Okay, guys, we took the TV out of the box, and what we're doing is we're mounting the assembly to go onto the articulating mount. So it's very important. These screws are very important that they're not too big or they're not too long, because you can ruin the display. So you want to make sure. So I already, in the package, in all mounts, guys, there's a whole bunch of series of screws that for different televisions, universal screws that'll fit with whatever application you're doing. So I already went through that, and so now I'm putting down the rails, and you just kind of, you don't want to force these in, guys. You just want to just put it in hand tight. You don't want to over tighten these, okay? You don't want to over tighten these. So what'll happen is this will go on here like that. So when we get the frame mounted on the back of the TV, it then goes on the articulating mount. There's security fasteners so the TV doesn't fall down. And we'll get to that point in a moment. But until then. So guys, I got the TV up. I got the speaker rack on. And I'm just about ready to make my cuts for the low voltage wiring. And you know, HDMI and video games, stuff like that. But this is going to be a customized AV plate for video games. So this will be a video plate for the Wii game or an older Sony PlayStation, what have you. I'm running three RCA cables right now up into here. And see how it goes. Sometimes going through the insulation is a little tricky.
Are you good now?
Nope. Alright, here it goes. This wasn't that bad. And that was real time, no editing. And so it wasn't too bad. So that's going to go directly into the TV. And this is going to go into an AV plate dedicated for video games. So we have here the two plates. This is going to be dedicated for HDMI and other AV equipment. This is going to be for the dedicated lines for the video games and stuff. So everything's going to be fed to up here, and that's going to be fed into the back of the TV. So this is where the center channel mount. We got the Boston Acoustics self-powered sound bar. It's going to be mounted here, and all that wiring is also going to go into that box there. What's nice about the soundbar is that it's got nice sound, and it's got a powered subwoofer that's wireless, so that's pretty good. So guys, what I'm doing now is I'm running two HDMI lines all at once to the TV. One's going to be for a Blu-ray player, the other going to be for a high definition cable. Let's see how this one works out. The HDMI gotta be really sensitive. Keep the caps on when you're running them through. It's very important. And here we go. This is an outside wall, so insulation makes it running wire a little tricky. So what I did here, I customized this plate. This cable line was just coming out of the wall with no plate. So I put a plate in here, just hooking up the U-verse now. So that I'm gonna fire that up in a little while. And what I use is a compression fitting. So when I do all my RCA connectors, custom connectors for RCA or RF, I use compression fittings. Here's something unique. These are bullnose covers. Okay, it allows the wires to come through. What's nice about the bullnose covers is that it allows less points of error. And what I mean by that is, unlike a connector like this, this connector is not going to be utilized often, so that's why I use this. These our two HDMI cables. They're going to be utilizing this all the time. In my opinion, the best source of connection is from your components to the display with no interruption. And you'll have more a better connection, less points of failure, and I like doing it that way. So if I can make a regular pass through without any interruption, that's what I like to do. So I got that plate in. Here's the bullnose. I got the bullnose here and here. And again, what's nice about that is that even though it's a little easier to install, the quality that you get is good and it's a lot more reliable. And I say that because there's again, a lot less points of failure when you use continuous flow audio-video plates such as